what? If you're going to be the last act tonight, I'm glad it's Sister's Door because it'll go out with a bang.
They've got the confidence to be the last and not worry.
Are you ready to play?
All right, Dollhouse Vlog viewers, it's Friday once again. We got different shirts on, same pants. Anyway, we are back. I hope you've enjoyed the last two episodes. We've got another two of these series, I think you'd like to call them, installed for you. Now we're at the exciting part, which is the grand final. Got an Aussie shirt on because it's appropriate, because Kelly really loved us, and I think she was the one pushing for us to get through to the grand final. So, yeah, the grand final experience was very fun, wasn't it?
It was awesome, because we knew that when it was the grand final night, they're going to up the stage, they're going to up everything. I remember one thing I requested, because we got to request a few little things. I was like, I want two bass drums. Like, I just didn't care. I just said, get me two bass drums for the drum kit. And yeah, it happened.
And the cool thing about, like, people would say, oh, why'd you just do that? Why did you just go on TV and do this? But it was kind of a bucket list thing for us. Like, we wanted to do it as a bit of a bucket list thing. I've always wanted to know what these shows were like, and to see what it goes on behind the scenes and how much work is put into these shows, it does give you a good insight to what goes on behind the scenes in that sort of entertainment world.
So we kind of looked at it as well. We're like, what are we going to do? Go play another gig at a pub to, like, yeah, and at the time we're still growing as a band, or we go and do the TV thing and play to millions across Australia.
And like we said from the get-go, we never thought we'd get as far as we did, so we just kind of milked it and enjoyed the experience while it lasted. And
yeah,
to get to the grand final was a lot of fun. And yeah, we really amped it up, like, with our attire on the red carpet. The red carpet was a lot of fun. Like,
we had to pick a new outfit and we wanted to go for a colour.
Yeah.
So we were like,
we'd done red, we'd done pink, and they were kind of our colours we kept alternating, like,
throughout touring.
When we were touring and that, because that's all we kind of had. And then it was like, let's go something completely different. So we went blue.
Blue.
I actually reckon we looked great. This was probably the best we looked. Yeah, and like we said, we got to dress ourselves, which was always fun. And like the wardrobe people and the makeup people, give a big shout out to them if they're watching. They were great people.
They were awesome.
And
like, even though we didn't need stuff, like the stuff we're wearing, we didn't need ironed and that. But we'd leave our stuff there overnight, didn't we? Mm. Like in our own dressing room and that. And then they'd pamper it and look after it.
My makeup artist was saying to us, oh, we love doing you guys because you just give us something to do. They go, we've kind of been, like, it's just been basic makeup, but for us, they kind of, we let them do what they wanted, and we stayed true to what we were, but Bryce would go on to them every 2 seconds, oh, can I have some hairspray, or straighten this and do that. And this was our favourite song at the time, Good Day to Be Alive. We really believed in this song, and obviously it changed from this version to what the version is now that most of you know. So so stay tuned and enjoy this episode, which is the grand final where you get to see huge pyros, so enjoy.
Australia, this is it. Make some noise for Sister's Door!
For the grand final, they flew us up to Sydney for 10 days and we're up there rehearsing, getting like different shots, doing interviews and doing all sorts of stuff. But then it worked out we had a gig in Geelong. Remember we had the gig in Geelong, that big Motor City Fest? Yeah. So that was already pre-booked. So we kind of had to tell them that and they're like, yep, we can fly you back and fly you back up. So they actually flew us down. We went to Geelong, did the show. We pulled an all-nighter. And I remember we were sitting at Macca's because we thought we'll sit at Macca's like in Geelong and kill time because there's no point coming all the way back home and then going back to the airport. We're like, we'll just pull it all-nighter. So we went to Macca's.
Oh no, nothing for me, thanks. I'm full.
And I left my phone in the toilet, remember? Black mirror. And we're driving back. We kind of got like an hour out of Geelong and I was like, my phone.
You did.
So
you
we had to turn phone. Around, go all the way back to that Macca's.
I remember
get
that.
Get my phone, wow. Yeah, and then drive all the way. And then by the time we got to the airport, it was pretty much, yeah, jump on the plane and go, because it was like a 5 a.m. flight. Ah. And then we literally, that night, we had no sleep. We went straight to the hotel, then we had to go all day to rehearse and do the final performance. And we performed that night, Good Day to Be Alive, for the first time on TV, and with pretty much no sleep. And not that we're making excuses or anything, but that's literally what happened behind the scenes. So it was fun, and that's what rock and roll is. And it kind of added to the story, because then when the producers and people knew that, and even other contestants were like, what? You did a gig last night, have you slept? And we're like, no, we haven't, we're just kind of...
I think for the gig we did in Geelong, we had like, because you wanted to save your guitars and bass and all that sort of stuff, and clothes and stuff.
So we had like backup guitars that I think, was it Jim? Jim met us.
Yeah.
Jim met us with the bus that had all our gear in it, and then we drove from the airport out to Geelong. We did the gig, and then obviously the phone story, and then we came back to the airport, flew to Sydney, did the show, and then the next night was the live decider, which, yeah.
Right on, guys. Well done, Kelly. Wow.
What a way to end the show, really. I mean, we went out with a bang tonight. That for sure. And you know what? It is a good day to be alive, especially for you, especially for all of us. And that was a great song, a great performance.
Thank you. Nico.
Look, it's very hard not to like you guys. You probably could have done a cover tonight. This is party time tonight. Well, no, I'm just telling you because it's hard to fall in love with a song on one hearing. But, you know, if you just come here to expose your music, you've done a good job.
Thank you. Cheers. Thanks.
Cheers.
I
just have
another
f***ing bastard. I have to agree with Dicko with the song because I wanted to sing along and I was kind of like, I don't know the words. Like, I think you guys are such...
It's a good day to be alive.
Yeah, I got it now. but obviously, you're great writers. So cute, all of you. So charming. I feel like you know the girls love you. I loved when you were drumming and you did this, like...
Not easy, is it?
I'll teach you that later.
Okay. yeah, clearly I'm not a rock star. But I really enjoyed that. Thank you.
Oh, thanks.
Thanks.
Eddie?
Look, I kind of agree and disagree with Dicko at the same time. Yes, it would be a smart choice if you wanted to be a contender to win this competition, to do something that everyone knows and they can wrap it around themselves like a warm blanket. But there are occasions when you're... an original band and you just can't stomach the idea of doing other people's songs, and I know what that feeling is and you can't go against that. It's a beautiful kind of rock anthem love song. I just was struck by the fact that you're, you know, brothers, and that's really bizarre. You've created a bizarre world for yourself, but it looks like a lot of fun, and I wish you guys all the luck in the world. Thank you for that.
Thanks, man.
Thank you.
Cheers.
Thanks, everyone. Appreciate
Thank you.
It.
A little bit of contradictory because they didn't air how we actually did a cover, so like, and then we did do a cover, so it was a little bit, but yeah, that's TV
like,
for you.
TV, and we finally got our pyro that we wished for, which was that, we weren't even expecting that much.
No,
but it was
like, no.
When
no.
we said, oh, what are we getting? They just like, we did the rehearsal, showed us, and we're like, oh, that's nuts, and we love that. From then, we're like, oh, we'd love to have that pyro curtain every show, like every gig we do. And one thing that was kind of really humbling for us is, and the producers actually told us, they said, you guys are closing out the show, which is like a huge honor because they say opening the show and closing the show is generally the most view times for people. Yeah. And so they said for you guys to be closing the show, that means that you put on a good show for that reason. So we're kind of very humbled by that. Plus, we didn't really care about the outcome. We're just like, let's just go out and have some fun. We kind of treated it more like they're at a Sisters Doll show rather than the competition. So it was on. And I just want to add too, like this was 4 years ago. And since then we have grown a lot more as musicians. So yeah, don't rate us on these performances because it was 4 years ago now. So we just wanted to share it with you because some of you may not have seen it. Some new fans may not have seen this footage. So but make sure you tune in next week. Same time, same place. I'll most likely be wearing the same pants.
And I'll be wearing a different shirt, but the same pants with a bit of schmutz on it, right?
But we've hoped you've enjoyed these vlogs so far. We've got one more installment for you, which is the Live Decider, where we get to play Dollhouse one more time. It went back to the public vote into the top five for the Live Decider. And we were lucky enough to get announced. But we didn't know any of this until on the night. So it was literally, we were just as shocked as everyone else on the stage. So when they announced us, we're like, wow, cool. And all we were excited about...
wow, cool.
But all we were excited about really is for people to see the stage set that they'd come up with for us, because it was kind of what we'd always envisioned for our stage for if we were on like a big production. Yeah. So the sad thing is we had to rehearse just in case we did get in. So they had like everything set up for like whoever went in. Yeah. So
all stage sets were prepared. Yeah. And ours was, and we got to see it and we were like, oh,
and perform with it.
Man, we'd love to perform with this. This is like what we've envisioned for so long since we came up with the Dollhouse concert.
And all the producers were saying backstage are like, oh, we hope you get in. We're like, yeah, we do too, mainly because we want everyone to see this Dollhouse stage you've got going for us. So when they announced our name, we were just like,
holy shit.
Yeah. So then we had to get into like focus mode and get ready to kick some ass again and
So
we'll kind of cover all that in the next thing anyways.
Thanks for watching us. We're Sisters Doll. Have a good night. Dollhouse Vlogs.
Over and out.
Don't let your meatloaf.
What do I say?
I say over and out.
I don't even know what I say.
Wow. That was something. It's amazing to see you guys rising from the ashes like the phoenix.
Yes!
We'd love to have that pyro curtain every show.